Praise the Lord. Can you give that another beautiful one? And I'm always happy when it comes to praising God, because in praises, God does wonders. And again, as you've done that, this will not be your last in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray for fresh anointing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
By this time next year, you wouldn't be found wanting in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I believe this will be incomplete if we don't like share one or two words with each other. Because it is important that we understand that we are in the presence of God. And if we come here and dance and clap, and we don't remind ourselves about Christ's word, then it is incomplete. Amen.
Yeah.
And we want to be complete, right?
Yes.
So that's why we're going to go into like just few minutes words. And then I pray that this will bless me in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us pray. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we give you all the glory, all the praise, all the adoration, accept our thanks in Jesus' name. We're going into your words. We pray that you speak to us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, Lord, we pray that you speak to us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Meet all our desires in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Fix us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Reform us, remold us, reshape us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Transform us fully.
Amen.
So that we always have reason to glorify your holy name.
Amen.
All this we ask in Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is good. And all the time. I'm going to spend 2 hours. Praise the Lord. I'm good. But it is interesting to me when it comes to the Word of God. Maybe it is what all our daddies or our mothers need to look into, because every time I say that, wherever I go to minister, I get the same reaction. When I say I'm going to spend 1 hour, everybody say, "Eh, yeah." Is it because we've had enough of the Word of God? Is it because we don't feel like the Word is meeting our needs? I mean, something must be going on there for me to get the same result. Maybe it's just me looking at it from that perspective. But every time I say that, I get the same reaction. Praise the Lord. I will say, I want more of you, I want more of you, but we don't want to listen to it, so I'm not going to spend 1 hour here, I was just joking. Amen. I will keep it as short as possible, I promise you that. Maximum, probably 15 minutes, that's the max. Amen.
Amen.
And my time starts from now. 5 minutes. Okay, 5 minutes. Amen.
Amen.
So I would call this... I want to look at the book of Luke chapter 1, because we are celebrating Christ, I believe. So Luke chapter 1, and we'll take it from verse 25. Are we there? Or we can take it from 26 to be precise. Luke 1, 26. Yes.
The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth.
Yes.
To a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, a descendant of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled by his word and began to wonder about the meaning of this greeting. So the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found a favor with God. Listen, you will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord will give him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will never end." Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I have not had any sexual relation with a man?"
God bless you. You can stay. Stop there. God bless you. I'm just going to work on that because I've only got 5 minutes, like I said, and I'm sure it's almost 5 minutes. Anyway, so I will tap this. Are you ready? That's why I will tap this. Because we are looking at an angel appearing to a woman that is preparing to be married. She was in the middle of preparation of getting married. And I want to say to us that now that we celebrate Christmas and we celebrate it in merriment, in happiness, we dance, we clap, and it's a good thing. But I want to let us know that the first Christmas wasn't celebrated in merriment and all of that. It was celebrated in disorganization, in trouble. A woman wanted to birth a child, but there was no place. Even though she had a visitation from an angel. Amen. She had a visitation from an angel, and the angel came and appeared and said, "Blessed are you amongst women, and this and that and that and that." And for when we get vision, like you're going to be great, you're going to be prosperous and all of that, we often get happy, but we're not prepared for the other part. Because the angel appeared, but he didn't tell her what she would go through to have the blessed child. Amen. But he did say, "Blessed are you." And one thing struck my mind. He said, "You're going to bear a child." And she was like, "How can this be when I know no man? I'm a virgin. How can a virgin bear a child?" And I know some of us have been telling us in our life that this will happen to you. You're going to be great. You're going to be prosperous. You're going to have a beautiful family. And you're thinking to yourself, "How can this be? Since I wasn't raised in a matrimonial home, how can I have a husband? How can I go to uni since I don't have the right papers to stay in this country? How can this be since I don't have a job? How can this be?" And we question ourselves. But when God says something, He does it. Amen. Your circumstance doesn't matter. The people around you doesn't matter. And I'm bringing it to a close. People around you don't matter. When God don't need your approval to do things that He will do. Amen.
Amen.
He doesn't need anyone's consent to do what He will do.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
But put a footnote. Because you've been visited by an angel doesn't exempt you from trouble. Because she was visited by an angel, and the angel Gabriel often give good messages. That's what angel Gabriel does. So because you've been visited by an angel doesn't exempt you from problem. When God promises you something, get ready for trouble. Amen.
Amen.
The people that don't encounter trouble is people that are not expecting anything. Amen.
Amen.
If you want to be trouble free, don't expect anything. Just sit down and eat muffin, drink a cup of tea, sleep, wake up. No trouble. Amen. But when you have something great in you, get ready for problems. Because I wouldn't know that you're great, and you wouldn't be able to testify that you're great if you can't show me what you've been through to be there. Amen.
Amen.
You can't tell me that you're great if you can't tell me that you're strong if you haven't been. You can't tell me that you're rich if you haven't been poor. Amen. You can't tell me that you have healing if you haven't been sick. Because we raised a generation, this generation of Christianity, are Christians that want to proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord and is a great healer, but we don't want to be sick. We want to be able to proclaim that He's a provider, but we don't want to be broke.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
But it is my sickness that gives me access to illness. I mean, to the healer. Amen. So if I haven't been sick, how can I be healed? Some of us are sick, but we can't even admit it. Amen. Let us rise up. I have more to say, but I don't have the time to say it. But I'm sure we'll meet again.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We're just going to say this one prayer. That God, please, put your love in my heart. Because I believe we have more Christians around here, but we have empty seats. Amen.
Amen.
And I believe Christianity should grow higher.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In faith, in numbers, whenever they call gathering of Christians, I believe they should have space for us.
Yes, true.
Sounds we have work to do, right? So let us pray that God, I need more of you. Let me love you more. Amen.
Amen.
That's just a simple prayer. Prayer. Tell God that teach me how to love you more. Teach me how to want you more. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, King of Glory, we want to give you all the praises once again because you've spoken to us. I pray that these fruits shall be a good season in our life in Jesus' name. As we've listened today, oh Lord, my Heavenly Father, I pray that you begin to do your wonders in our life in Jesus' name. Every area we are sick, begin to heal us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every area we are broke, continue to provide in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Transform us for good in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Our life will never remain the same in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. All this we ask in Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Clap for Jesus. And now I'm going to call on another sister of mine to come and lead us in praises and worship. And I believe that something great will happen in our life tonight in Jesus' name. I'm going to call on Sister Funke to come forward. We really appreciate you in our life.
Yeah.